Welcome to my tech channel GTA Tech. Today we're gonna talk about what is a PC, what does it, and why you may be trying to build a PC. First of all, when you build a PC, when you're starting or thinking of building a PC or making a people, I would just say one thing or maybe more things. That is, I have experience about pre-built and built PC, because pre-built, you pay extra for the price. You don't know self how to do it a lot. Yeah, I would say just pay extra for the money. It's not even tradable in the future. There's a lot of non-customizable things you cannot do, and you're not knowing what to do. They just build it for you, and you don't know nothing about it. And it's a good idea to build by yourself, because you can choose your own parts, you can choose the color, you can make a personality into the build, you can make it upgradable. Features upgradable very easy in the future. My example, my new PC I built right here on the right side is actually my own built PC. I built it by myself, and my old PC was a pre-built one, and it was not upgraded for me because I was doing something bigger. So I built a whole new system, and took some of the old parts to a new, like the graphics card, and the storage, and a Wi-Fi card. But otherwise, everything is new, case, fans, everything. And that is the bad thing about a pre-build. You can't do very much about it. It's not upgradable. It costs a lot of money. You can't do your own personal touch on it. So I would say, if you have a friend, or if you're afraid of it, you can maybe find a friend that wants to help you. Or you can watch a lot of time-lapse, step-by-step tutorials, how to build a PC, tips and tricks on YouTube. There's a lot. So if you want to follow a step-by-step build PC, there's a lot out there, you can just do that. It's very easy to build a PC. I would say it's very simple, because I was a little bit afraid at the start, but after I got the parts and looking at it, and then build it, it was very easy step-by-step build. So say, go for it, it's the best thing to do, and you would definitely be happy with what you did. And I also had two friends that helped me a little bit, but I did most of the things, and I was like surprised how easy it was to build a system. First of all, when you build a system, also don't do single channel mode, do dual channel mode, because if you use a single mode, like a 16 gig instead of 2x8 gig, you have less work with. If you're using 2x8, they can literally, two sticks can work instead of one stick need to work all the things there is on the PC. So go with two and give you more FPS and looking better, I will say. And what is a PC? What does a PC actually? It's too many things. It can, it can do stuff for you that you may be not able to do, or you don't have the time to do. It can do a lot of stuff. And how does a PC works? That is, you have a RAM, you have a GPU, CPU, and then you have like motherboard that are the main part, and CPU is the main thing in the PC. The CPU is going into the motherboard, so the CPU is like the brain of the PC. It does all the work almost, and if you're like gaming like me, then you need a graphics card to render the other stuff, 3D stuff, and give you FPS and all that stuff. But a workstation, you don't need a graphics card. If you have a workstation, you don't need a big graphics card, you don't need like expanding, you can just use the integrated stuff. I have a laptop that is not graphics card, just integrated graphics in the CPU. That is for work, so no problems. That is for working. But if you're gaming and making 3D things and doing like heavy stuff, you need a heavy CPU, you need a decent graphics card and all that stuff to help it. But mainly, if you do heavy stuff, you need more cores. If you don't do heavy stuff, you don't need that many cores. Like in my process, I have 6 cores. 16 threads. Our PC has 4 cores, 4 threads. So yeah, I can definitely feel like I have 6 cores to do different stuff. So I can do more multitasking, all the stuff. Also, because I chose a Ryzen processor, and a Ryzen processor is meant for multitasking. If you do more than one thing mainly, and Intel is for single core processing. So if you're only gaming, example, or only working, it's good choice. But if you're like me, making content creation and gaming at the same time, or doing most of, you need a core that can do multiple things and are good to multitasking, then RAM. RAM is like the thing that's also loading the stuff when you're opening tabs. Like, desto more RAM you have, desto more can you render and stuff, desto more tabs can you actually have open. So yeah, that's why I'm saying dual channels is the best. So, and what RAM should you choose when you're building a PC? That's also a good question. First of all, you need a CPU and you need to choose what brand it is. Intel, AMD. AMD is like multitasking. If you're content creator and maybe gaming or doing multiple stuff, it's AMD you're going for. If you're doing one thing only and going for single core processing, like only doing one stuff, then you're going for Intel. And then after that, you need a motherboard that can handle the series days and also the processor, and it's not getting too overheated and all that stuff. So if you're going for a DIMM, you need a AMD motherboard, and if you're going for Intel, you need an Intel motherboard. And when you choose RAM, it's best to what frequency and how much you should run with. If you are using Ryzen, you should go for high RAM, because they have Ryzen have like a better potential if you use a higher RAM and higher clocks and better seal. You can also use a Intel, but higher speed on RAM is definitely good to Ryzen processor. And if you're choosing Intel, is not it, you don't need to think about 3600 megahertz. Then you just need like Intel only like 3200, because it's like I don't know what, but they don't need that much high speed RAM. AMD is taking advantage of the high speed RAM, and you can overclock with AMD. There's also overclocking on Intel, but then you need a K version, and Intel is very locked processor. All AMD's processor is overclockable, and you can also overclock the RAM in it. So the RAM you have, then you come to the cooler. You can get you have the stand stock cooler from Intel and AMD. If you're going for ADM, you have a pretty good stock cooler that can pretty good cool the CPU. If you don't have the money for it, or you want to go budget, like don't have money for the things, then you could go with stock cooler on a Ryzen processor. But if you're using Intel, I will definitely not ever use a stock cooler on Intel, because it is terrible. It's the worst quality ever. And don't go for it. Just buy another cooler, and you can go for air cooling, or you can go for liquid cooling, like AIO, water cooling. There's multiple things you can go for. You can go for air cooling, but that is just not a good idea. You can do it, but then you need a lot of air pulling out and in. I know I have only on my PC actually, but I'm actually bought a liquid IO cooler to my CPU, so I'm also using water, so it's not only air, so it's not getting too hot. And Intel, it's actually don't need to have that big cooler. I will say AMD is getting more hotter than Intel, but also because AMD have a lot of more cores and threads, and it's a little bit more powerful on overclocking side. If you want to overclock, you need a better cooler, because if you're overclocking, you getting more heat, you need to have that heat out of the CPU, you need to spread that heat out of the case, you need to get it out because it's getting more hotter, you're pushing the CPU over, so it's getting more hot and need to run faster. Intel, you don't need to think about that, because a lot of Intel coolers, a lot of Intel CPUs is locked, so you can't overclock them. So you don't need to think about that. And when you're choosing motherboard, you should choose one that is compatible with the series you're choosing. Otherwise, it's Intel or AMD, which series it is. You should think about that when you also, if you want to future-proof it, like I did, you need to also buy a motherboard that can also handle the new series that is coming out to the PC, like coming out on the market. If you're going for Intel or AMD new series, or motherboard that compatible with the new series, and also that series you're going with, and the same as Intel. Then we have like the graphics card. You can go for AMD or what is called, GeForce. What is called? I don't know. I just know it's NVIDIA, 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 And it's Nvidia or AMD you have. AMD, I will say, is budget, or it's definitely not the best graphics card you can choose. If you want to go for good graphics card, you should go for Nvidia because they make really good graphics card. AMD is a little bit behind the graphics card things, and there's a lot of good features on Nvidia, but there's not a lot of good. There's good features on AMD, but there's more good features of features on Nvidia instead of AMD. So we'll definitely choose for Nvidia, but that's your prefer. If you want to go for AMD, you can do for that. You can also go for Nvidia. It's your choice. It's what you are gonna use the PC for, is that matter. So if you're gonna use it for single coring, Intel. If you're going for multi-coring, AMD, and then otherwise on RAM and graphics card. And then we have the power supply. Power supply is the most important thing of the PC, actually. The power supply is gonna run all your things. So if you don't have a big enough power supply to handle the stuff, it's gonna blow up. So you need a good power supply that have more. So if you want to upgrade it, you have the space to it. And also you need to power your peripherals, your PC, your whole thing need to have power. So you need a good power supply that is good cooling, and it's a good known brand that make good quality one. You can go for modular or modular, like a different one, but just go for one that is good and can, you know, that can handle your CPU and all the stuff you're putting into your system. And then the last part, it's actually the case, actually not the last part, we also need to start, but the case, that is your choice when you're making a build PC that is really good. Because pre-built, you can choose a lot of things in that. You can't choose the parts that much, the color, whatever. If build PC, you can choose whatever case there is, and there's a lot of case, there's a lot of good. I will say definitely go for Lian Li. Lian Li make good cases. Corsair is actually making good cases. There's a lot of brands. They're making good cases, so definitely go and see what you like, and if you see what you like and then choose what you like and then go for it. And then we have the most important, storage. You need to have enough space to all your things you want to download on. An example, if you're gaming, you probably need a lot of storage because games is big in the time now. I have a 2 TB SSD, and then there's different storage. There's a SSD, SATA, and then there's a hard drive. I would probably say if you want to do something, you go for SSD that have Windows on it and can boot the system really high, no, really fast. Because hard drive is not that fast to boot system, it's old, it's mechanical. And then start with SSD for the Windows to boot up, and have that Windows on the SSD, and then use a SATA for your storage if you want to. And if you have like a lot of pictures that is not need to go that fast, you can power down a hard drive. Hard drive is more less a lot less expensive, and SATA is also less expensive. SSD is really expensive. Why? Because it's so fast. It's really fast. SATA is faster than a hard drive, but it's not fast as faster SSD. But you can get a lot of space and a lot of money for a SATA and SSD. It's actually affordable, I will say. But hard drive, if you really want to go crazy, you can actually buy a lot of storage on a hard drive for very, very less money. So that was it. I hope you liked the video. If you have any question, then wonderful ask. And just so you know, if you want to hit me, then I have a Discord. I will link it down in the description. I also have a Twitch. I go live there every second day. We talk about things, and we game a lot of stuff. We are gaming mostly Apex and a lot of more stuff. So if you have any question, then comment in the description, or catch me on the Discord or the stream. I would love to see you there. And then also, if you like the video, like and subscribe. Appreciate you all being here. And if I missed anything, then comment down below. Or if you have any ideas what I should do next, then comment it. I would love to. Peace. Punch out. Bye.